And now, we'd like to take you into more intermediate level dancing. And we're going to do this time syncopations and rhythm breaks. And what those are, that's when the partners are dancing and they're doing different timings with their feet, different movements, but they're still dancing together. Now, it takes a little more concentration, but it's a very important lesson to be able to become a real good dancer. So that, what I try and tell people is, when we're dancing together, we still have 99% freedom. People don't realize that. They think you lock on to each other, and it's not true. You still get to dance all you want. That 1% is just for the partner to give an indication, give some lead or some follow. Okay. So what we're going to do is start first with the ladies. We're just going to do a regular sugar push. Okay, regular sugar push, you take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, just like you learned in beginning level. Okay, so now the guy can be doing the sugar push, and he's not led. These syncopations and rhythm breaks, for the most part, are not led. The lady does them on her own, and the guy does them on his own. So this gives you a fair amount of freedom in your dance. Okay, so now she comes in, she wants to syncopate, he's just doing a sugar push, and she'll come in and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so she's doing a cross rock. Then she's doing a drag and she's doing a knee swivel after that. So what happens for the ladies, it changes. We'll bring Julie over here so we can see that better, ladies. And she's also changing her timing. Instead of doing 1, 2, 3, and 4, she's doing 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're playing with the timing a little bit. This is a mark of a better dancer. So when she comes in here, 1, 2, she turns sideways and she does a small rock step. And goes out to the side. She's not facing the partner. Then she brings the left knee over the right knee, and then she swivels it back in to that side. Now, when you come back here, you don't have to be facing the partner. Okay? You can over-twist it a little bit, because then when you do your walk, then you'll come into the partner. Okay? So guys, you're just doing the regular thing. You're just doing a sugar push like normal. 1, 2, you put this hand up, and she just jumps in there. Right. Now, when you feel her do that, for the guys, try not to stay flat. When she comes in and starts turning out a little bit, try and do the same thing. You notice I turned my body to the right because she did. Now I can go with her and she can do her swivel. So let's look at that again for the ladies. She comes in and no bouncing, ladies. A lot of times the ladies do a rock step and they dip. No dip, it always stays very level. The only thing you do here, 1, 2, 3, right here is you push the hip out a little bit. Usually we stay pretty straight. But now we're going to push the hip out into the knee twist. Okay, and then she's going to swivel and do the walk in. So from this side, let's see it so we can see the knee twist a little bit better. Okay, so we're in here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now right here, notice her feet are actually turned away. Her body's actually turned away from the partner a little bit. Okay, and her left knee is over her right knee. And then she just switches. She puts right over left. So for ladies, you can do this. You can practice your exercise by putting your left knee over and your right. Left, right, left, right, left, right. And this is a good exercise also because while you're dancing, your knees should be relating to each other all the time. Even when you're passing legs, they should not be open. We don't use turn out like you do in ballet. This is swing dancing. So we actually use turn in. Our toes are straight, but we actually turn our knees towards each other. It's very efficient and very helpful for you to do your turns and things like that and for a sense of balance. Okay? So we're here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Right there, okay? So it's a cross rock and a drag for the ladies with a knee twist. Okay. Now, for the guys to match that a little bit, he can also do a syncopation. Now for him, he's going to come back and go 1, 2, the same type of 3, 4 movement. 1, 2, he's going to do a rock step. 3, 4. And he's going to come forward. So you notice there, instead of doing the touch or the triple step, well, we did a triple step, but we changed the timing to 3. We also did a rock step. 3, 4, and we went forward. Now here, we're going to do a sailor shuffle. And what I like to do is show people how to do the full sailor shuffle before we do the half. We're just going to do a half of one. So for the guys, you're like this, guys. Here's what a sailor shuffle is. We go out to the side, we cross behind, we take a side step and forward, okay? Cross, side, and this foot scoots forward. Cross, side, forward. Cross, side, forward. That's called a sailor shuffle. Cross, side, forward. Cross, side, forward. just like that. Now, we're going to do half of that. That'll take some practice. That'll take a little practice to get used to that. But that's what you're here to do, is to get some different things going with your feet so you can play with the music a little bit. So when he comes here, he's going one, two, three, four. We angle a little bit, and we go cross, side, forward, and we're done. Okay? And we don't have to be facing the partner. It's a little better. As a matter of fact, for all our dancing, it's a little better not to face the partner. If we're slightly off to the left or right, that's better, because it creates a sense of continuity rather than ending your pattern and coming back to another pattern. So it flows a lot better. So, with a partner, now both of us have a similar timing. One, two, three, four. She does a draw, and then she does a knee swivel as he's doing cross, side, forward, and then we go here. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two. Now, same thing happens. She can do this on her own. As a matter of fact, she probably will. And the guy can do it on his own. But a lot of times when ladies feel it, when they feel them going into a syncopation, it sort of invites her to do it. So all these syncopations, most of them are not led. This gives, especially the lady, a lot more individual expression. Triple step. Remember, the same thing with your hands and everything. When she comes in here, it looks like I'm pushing her a lot, but I'm not. She's absorbing these arms, and so am I. When I come out, watch when I go with her. We don't push off the hands that much. I'm pushing off the floor. She's pushing off the floor. We have a very light connection over here, and this is where things get mixed up a lot of times. People think, you know, they're supposed to push, and that's not true. We come one, two. We're both into each other. Okay? I go. I don't push my arms. I go with her here. That's a much better lead, guys, if you can push from the floor rather than your arms. You notice I went with her, and then I let go, and she does her swivel. So try and keep that in mind. And there you have a couple syncopations, a cross rock and drag for the ladies, and a syncopation with a sailor shuffle for the guys.